If you haven't watched the first part of my sprue adventures, I advise you doing just that before proceeding. This video is about iterating upon my previous experiences and doing my best to create new minis from discarded sprues. I'm Shonko and this is Eastwind. The first thing I wanted to improve is my mold making skills. Previously the two parts of my mold stuck together and also it had a lot of bubbles. I set out to fix both of these issues. I improved a bit on the mold design. Judging by the previous casting, my theory is that I need to keep the air exposure of the actual cast to the minimum and at the same time keep the sprue goo mix liquid as long as possible. I added a lid to the design and also widened the pyramid shape to a V-shaped wedge. I used an old piece of forgeworld resin that was just the right size and fixed a piece of plastic card on top. I didn't glue it in, since the idea was to use the same piece later. I imagined I would just scoop in the sprue goo as fast as I can, then put the lid on it, thereby slowing the evaporation process. After a few hours or a day or so, I'd remove the lid and the goo that is now settled into the mold can solidify. So with the master done, I made a quick mold box from cardboard and hot glue. This worked well enough previously, so I stuck with it. This time I took extra care with the silicone mold preparation. I stirred it thoroughly, put the mix on top of my vortex mixer, sadly I didn't realize that was off camera, tried to get out as many bubbles as possible. I also poured it in a very thin stream from high up, and I could see during the pour that it already looked better. Now it was time to pour the second half, and that entailed figuring out a mold release that works. I ordered some actual purpose-made mold release, but I performed an experiment with two silicone chunks first. The first one got coated in olive oil, the second I used hairspray on, but this time a copious amount to be extra sure. The olive oil barely did anything, but the hairspray produced some effects. It was still hard to separate without damaging it, but it wasn't as bad as the first time. I suspect previously I used the wrong type of hairspray and also not enough of it. I considered simply using a spray primer to provide a separating layer, then it hit me. Varnish would probably work better. I remember that I had a rattle can of matte varnish somewhere. I originally bought it because I wanted to build a chaos army, seal the minis with it, then brag about having an army of mad demons. But that didn't happen and I couldn't find the rattle cam. So I had to use some gloss varnish and I brushed that on. This pulled a lot, so I did multiple passes and later stippled it on rather than brushing it. It still looked patchy, so I plastered it with hairspray for good measure and hoped for the best. I constructed and glued on the box for the top part, mixed up the silicone and poured it. It definitely seemed like that I have improved here. I left it overnight to solidify, then started to carefully, anxiously separate it. This time it separated much easier, even though I had to help it with a knife. The varnish hairspray worked well enough, and I actually had a serviceable two-part mold. The quality seemed very good too. The damage on top is not the fault of the mold, but rather just the imprint of the glue on the top of the D20. This was now perfect for testing. I also thought about how to get the sprue goo better to its destination. I tried to use a syringe to scoop it up from the bottle, but that simply didn't work. It only sucked up acetone. I also acquired a tube squeezer for an improved goo injection system. So I prepared the plastic outlet, scooped up some goo and tried to work as fast as possible. It is important to wear gloves because acetone is a carbohydrate and you shouldn't eat that. This is how people who do nails get fat. I forced in as much material as I could and put the lid on. And in a stroke of last minute genius, I put a plastic container upside down on the whole contraption. I hoped this would slow the evaporation down just enough. I waited about 2 days to open it. I tried to remove the plastic art from top, but I realized that it is made from the same material as the sprues, so it just fused together with the goo. Well, that is fine, I guess. Time for the reveal. You can see here that the texture has vastly improved. That is definite success, however, I only managed to cast half a die. Sadly, this does not make it a D10. By examining the cast, it is my impression that my idea did work. The still liquid sprue goo flowed down to the mold nicely, but not fast enough. The air exposure was also limited by the wedge on top. I believe the small bubbles on the D20 were caused by the trapped and displaced air in the mold itself. The wedge was also way more pockmarked, consequence of more air exposure. So this was a very good step forward. I'm still not there, but this is a good partial success. For the next step, I plan to have some kind of enclosed box and basically keep the sprue goo liquid, possibly by topping it off with more solvent as I go along. There is also such a thing as rotocasting, where the mold is placed into some kind of spinning device and the centrifugal force helps the material into the mold from the top. I really want to build as much of this as I can from household materials or outright trash, so I need to figure out how can I do that here. I think a small engine or a power tool can do the job. In any case, that's all I have for now. Stay tuned for updates and please subscribe for notifications. Thanks for watching and see you later!